So today I want to talk to you about symptoms of reactive hypoglycemia and what you must know, learn, and do in order to understand what's going on in your body, if you really have it, and the things that you're going to need to do to be aware and actually fix the problem. My name is Dr. Joel Rosen. I am the founder of The Truth About Adrenal Fatigue, where we're on a mission to help 100 million burnt out adults learn the truth about their health so that they can get their energy back very, very quickly. So I want to talk to you today about what is reactive hypoglycemia and what are the symptoms and how do you know if you have it? So first and foremost is typically what reactive hypoglycemia is when your blood glucose levels fall after a meal, anywhere between 2 to 4 hours after, or even quicker than that, lower than 70 millimoles per deciliter. Now, how do I know what that number is? I typically am going to use a glucose meter. And when I test that glucose meter, I'll see that my glucose levels are less than 70. Now, I think there has to be some kind of increase in awareness on what exactly is going on. So what happens is, as you probably are aware, when you eat a food, especially if it's rich with sugars or refined carbohydrates, processed foods, things that are going to spike up your glucose very, very fast, that's called a high glycemic index or a high glycemic load. And what will happen is that will cause a surge of insulin released by your pancreas. And as a result, that surge will cause the cells to open up their doors and allow glucose to get in, causing a very, very quick rise of blood glucose because of the increase of sugar from the foods that you're eating, but then also a very, very quick and fast decline. So with that decline, symptoms are going to be shakiness, anxious, palpitations, can't focus, brain fog, headaches, stand up and decrease your blood pressure so you feel like you're going to faint. These are the things that we tend to, even nausea, vomiting, and depending on how severe it is, if you're actually testing your glucose and you go down into, say, the 50s and 40s, then this can be real cause for concern. And in this case, I would suggest that you talk to your primary care doctor to get more insight. But with that being said, what I think needs to change is that the whole goal of increasing your stability of your blood glucose is to make sure that you're eating proper foods and you're aware of all the dynamics that are causing your roller coaster ride of your blood sugar spikes. So what do I mean by that? Well, ultimately, there are different ways that we can process energy. We can either process it through burning glucose, and I call that the kindling. If you're going on a camping trip and you're going to light your logs, you're going to use a little bit of dry sticks and leaves to be able to ignite and burn and get that big log of wood to be able to burn for a long period of time. Basically, that's how our body works in terms of being able to use these different fuel sources for energy and prolonged energy. So obviously, if I had in one pile a twigs and branches and leaves, or I had in another pile the big log that is going to burn for long periods of time, which is going to be easier to light? Obviously, the twigs and the dry brush. Which is going to burn longer? Obviously, the big log. And ultimately, what happens is, based on our stress levels, based on our dietary habits, based on a lot of environmental things, and even genetic susceptibilities, will depend on what form of fuel are you burning predominantly. And my guess is, not even my guess, but if you're concerned about reactive hypoglycemia and you do get shaky, lightheaded, and jittery after a meal, or you happen to get dizzy or anxious or palpitations or nausea, and you actually measured your glucose, then you're a sugar burner. And our goal is to teach you how to become a log or healthy fat burner. And that's going to be in another video. But what I wanted to talk to you about this video was, A, making sure you're testing. And I'll post a link under this video so you can get the Keto Mojo, because that's the whole other point. Is if you go on the internet and you research what is reactive hypoglycemia, what are the levels that you need to have that, and you're in the 70s or lower, that's not necessarily reactive hypoglycemia if you're metabolically flexible. And what I mean by that is that if you haven't had meal for a while and you're not eating a lot of carbs, you're eating healthy proteins and fats, you're moving around and you're active and you're controlling your stress response and a lot of the nutrients you're eating are dense with vitamins and minerals, then that metabolic flexibility will allow you to start burning that log. And when you start burning that log, your glucose is going to fall because you're not creating a lot of spikes of your glucose levels. You're not creating a surge of insulin. What you're doing is you're burning healthy fats for fuel, and that takes a lot of oxygen. Just like if I had a flame here, I would want to put a little bit of oxygen or air behind it so it can ignite, and you need that oxygen to be able to do that. But the whole point of that is that when you're testing your glucose levels and you see that they're in the low 70s, you want to test your ketones to be able to see, are you spitting out ketones? Are you above 0.5 in millimoles on ketones? Because then you're not in a reactive hypoglycemic state. However, if you are shaky, lightheaded, jittery, anxious, you feel like you need to eat right away, you stand up and you get dizzy, or you feel like you're going to faint, chances are is that you're not producing any ketones whatsoever. So what do I need to do? Well, first and foremost, we need to change the diet. We need to get really good healthy fibers, things that slow down the glycemic surge and help to be able to create a very low, slow rise of your blood glucose. That requires a lot of good fiber foods. Getting good healthy fats, those are very, very important. Cutting out your refined sugars and processed foods. Just eating foods that grandma would recognize that weren't fast foods or packaged foods or artificial foods or foods that you're getting from a vending machine or a fast food place. Foods that are actually grown and planted and made from the earth. Seeds, nuts, legumes, healthy animal foods, proteins, vegan options, and of course, good healthy fats, nuts, seeds, healthy avocados, coconuts, oils, nut butters, dairy if you intend to do that. Grass-fed is very, very important. No hormones. And as you start to reduce your carb intake, refined sugars, and as you start to increase your healthy proteins and fats, all things being equal, you will see a better stability of your blood glucose levels. On top of that, there are other variables like gut health issues, a lot of stress, hormone imbalances, oxidative stress and inflammation, which are all topics for another video. But what I want you to do, if you've had a lot of value from this video, just make sure you give me a thumbs up. Make sure you give me a comment and let me know if you've actually tested your blood glucose levels and you see that they're less than 50 or 60 or 70. Let me know what the numbers were. Did you actually test your ketone levels to determine if that's a thing too? Because chances are when you see those levels be very, very low and you start to freak out, you'll lose that freak out moment because you'll see that your actual glucose levels are low, but your ketone levels are high if you've developed that metabolic flexibility. The other thing that happens a lot of the times is people might be reactive hypoglycemic in their thought process, meaning they eat a food and they get really, really tired and like that crash after a meal. But that's not necessarily reactive hypoglycemia. That could be some insulin resistance and metabolic issues, and your actually glucose levels are high. So it's really key that you test those glucose levels. So anyways, in our next video, we will talk to you about the factors of stress and how stress impacts the glucose levels through cortisol and adrenaline and pancreatic health and liver health. And until then, I look forward to helping you with your blood sugar imbalances. Have a great day.